When my sister and I packed up to move cross-country, I knew it was the right thing to do. But nothing could have prepared us for the road trip ahead.
Just wait till I'm of health, you evil little creature! I'll curse you with an entire life!
Just days ago, I sell the family house, plan the big move, and I'm on my way to Virginia Beach with my little sister, Jody. I knew she wasn't looking forward to the move, but I had to get away, especially from the house my parents left us after they died.
The movers should be here around 7, so we should be out of here around 9 or 10.
Our parents were killed soon after they adopted my little sister. I took custody of her.
Bye-bye.
She was all I had in the way of family.
Can we talk? If this is about the move, I can understand why you're upset. I'm going downstairs. Make sure you have everything packed by tonight. The movers are going to be here early in the morning.
Staying the whole school year.
God, I hate my sister.
What, for making you move?
What do you think, stupid? Well, Kyle's got something for you. May cheer you up.
Come on, Kyle, come on.
Well, I really hate to part with him, but here.
Slider, you're giving me Slider?
What the heck, he's just a stupid animal.
Don't say that about your pet.
He's your pet now.
Better than yesterday,
then?
A little better, but
sure.
I can't wait to get home.
so I'll pick something up on the way home.
Oh, Jason, I've got a message for you.
Okay. Bye-bye. Dr. Phillips wants you to transport a patient tomorrow.
Another one, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Up to Mansfield?
No, this one's going down to St. Paul's in Newtown.
Newtown?
Uh-huh. Here are his files. And, let's see, I'll lock up. Do you know where the buzzer is?
Mm-hmm.
Can you cover for me for a little bit?
Sure.
There's a new girl coming in if you just tell her that I had to leave a little early.
All right.
Okay, see you tomorrow morning.
Okay.
Newtown.
When did they unhook your cable?
So is Stacy gonna think of Slider?
Stacy? Stacy's not gonna find out about Slider.
Sounds kind of risky.
I know my mom would crack me a good one if she found one of those in my room.
Well, Stacy isn't my mom, and she isn't telling me what I can and can't have.
Real Talk on Independent Radio. I'm Chuck Rowe, in for the vacationing Dave Maxwell, who is, he's on vacation.
Hello?
Hi, Stacy. Kara.
Kara, I thought you were coming over.
I didn't want to get in the way. How are you coming along?
Pretty good. I've been packing all day. I'm on my last few boxes.
God, I still can't get over it. Stacy Parker's leaving the neighborhood. Sure you won't change your mind?
It's a little late now. Nope, I'm pretty dead set on it.
Taking care of Slider.
Shh, I can handle it.
You've got a job lined up, right?
Yeah, at an art gallery near the beach. I talked to the owner. I think she's going to let me showcase some of my art there.
Awesome. Well, I wish you the best of luck. I'm really going to miss you around here, you know.
I know. I just need to get away for a while, away from this house, especially. I don't know.
Hey, little
This is Dr. Jeffrey Phillips of the Rothman Center, Dayton, Ohio, with part one of the audio commentary on my patient and soon to be yours, the Keller boy. This boy came to us from the Valhalla Mills incident about a decade ago. Unfortunately, there really aren't many knowns in this case. The few facts we do have, however, concern his mother, Mavis Keller, once an in-home seamstress who lived in Valhalla Mills, Ohio, about 50 miles east of Cincinnati. Mavis was described by the few residents of Valhalla Mills as a recluse. About the only time anyone ever saw her was when she went into town for supplies or food, rarely speaking a word to anybody. It was assumed she had lived by herself. One day, residents spotted a little boy, shabbily dressed, walking through the covered bridge, the town's portal. Workers at the local sawmill later spotted this very same boy walking toward Mavis's house. Concerned or curious, they phoned police. Authorities arrived a few days later, and sure enough, they found the boy in an empty upstairs room of the house, holding a newborn baby. Even more puzzling, Mavis Keller was nowhere to be found, and to this day her disappearance remains a mystery. The children then became wards of the state. The baby girl was put up for adoption, and the boy was transferred here, where he's been my patient for just over 9 years. On the GAF, he scored a 41. For the most part, he's catatonic and physically inactive. Rarely does he exhibit any emotion. However, a particularly interesting symptom of his psychosis is his need to keep his face covered. When he first got here, he made himself a head cover out of torn bed sheets, and I decided to supply him with gauze because at least that enables him to breathe easier. Now, to some in your staff, his appearance may at first be disturbing, but I assure you, the patient is harmless.
Leave that by the door.
No, this is going in the car.
Oh. Oh, please be careful with that. It's my artwork.
No problem.
Shit.
Hey, what'd you do?
I got it.
Hey, what'd you do? Did you break something or what?
It's all right. I got it.
Indiana, Ohio, West Virginia, Virginia, four whole states? Man! Taking the highway.
Well, I don't know. I think the highway's kind of boring, don't you?
These back roads are what's boring. That's what I think.
Well, okay. How about if we take the back roads through Indiana and Ohio, and we take the highway once we get to West Virginia? That's about 50-50.
Back roads through Indiana and Ohio?
I can see this is going to be a real long trip.
That's affirmative.
Here's the mail, Karen.
Thanks. Good morning, Jason.
Hey. Haven't brought him down yet, huh?
Nope.
What's that?
Oh, looks like another one of your probation reports. How much longer do you have on probation?
Couple of months.
Well, you've been on pretty good behavior since you've been here. Late a few too many times, but I'll try and have the doc keep that out of the report for you, okay?
Thanks.
Oh, this goes with you.
So, what's with this patient I'm transporting today?
What do you mean, what's with him?
Well, I mean, what's the story on him? You know, with the bandages and all that crap.
Showing an interest in our patients?
Well, no, I'm just curious as to why nobody around here has mentioned anything to me about him before.
Maybe it's because you don't work the upstairs. Just a sec. Rothman Center may help you. Uh-huh. Right. Oh, that should be no problem. Sure. You're welcome. Well, sure. You're welcome. Jason!
Extra battery pack for the radio.
Where's the lock?
I don't know.
Don't make any other mistakes, okay?
Reggie? Dave?
Hey, you're all set, man.
He ain't moved an inch in years.
Thank you.
states to go.
What's up? Jody. I really hate this distance you put between us. I mean, you could at least pretend like you like me, maybe talk a little more or something, make the trip a little easier. I'm sorry if you're angry about the move, but you're gonna have to open up and face the facts sooner or later.
Probably lost us.
The Reds. The Reds, the Reds, the Reds. Riverfront Stadium? Sounds good. I'm kind of hungry. How about you? By the shirt shack. How about some Chinese? How about a big fat steak?
Traveling into Cincinnati from Warren.
Actually, I think I'm kind of hungry for a hot dog from Riverfront Stadium.
Come on for Heights, North Bend Road, southbound before I-74. Police on the scene of an accident. Several people injured.
Get your camera, now we can take a real picture. Hey, let's go. Even though the season's over, there might be a souvenir stand open.
Let's go.
Your reference, you're 1735 Cincinnati.
Showing an interest in our patients?
Well, no, I'm just curious as to why nobody around here has mentioned anything to me about him before.
That the Reds were in the first game ever shown on TV?
No, I didn't.
Yeah, they played the Brooklyn Dodgers. I think it was in 1953.
The Brooklyn Dodgers?
Yeah. Hey, maybe in May we could catch a game.
Sure, why not? Hey, we'll be really close to Baltimore. Do they have a team? Maybe we can go see a game there. What's the name of their team there? The Sox or the Hornets or... Why are you looking at me like that?
I have a lot to teach you about baseball.
Coffee? Anything else?
Looks like another one of your probation reports. How much longer do you have on probation? Rothman Center, how can I help you?
Weather for this November 14th. It's
going to be mostly cloudy and mild today for the most part across the Ohio Southland. Highs ranging from 48 to 53, dropping to the upper 20s by tonight. Maybe a spot of rain later this afternoon, but the radar is clear for the moment.
Can we take the highway now, please?
Hey, what about our deal? It's only a few hours till West Virginia.
Okay.
Took my eyes off for 2 seconds. 2 fucking seconds!
Some in your staff, his appearance may at first be disturbing, but I assure you, the patient is harmless.
Attention all units, there's been a report of a break-in at Terry's Body Shop, 3068 County Road 45. Repeating, a report of a break-in at 3068 County Road 45 North.
North.
Please, honey.
Look, I saw somebody leaving my shop and head off into the woods.
I reported it. I called the cops, okay?
I'll find him myself. The cops are too damn slow. Pretty easy to spot. He's wearing some of my work clothes.
Please be careful. Terry?
Thank you.
going to be making any money at this new job?
Of course, silly. Oh, that reminds me. I have to call Liz.
Liz?
Yeah, my new boss at the art place.
Why do you need to call her?
I need to tell her we'll be there tomorrow sometime.
Why? She knows we're moving this weekend anyway, right?
Right, smarty pants. You didn't let me finish. I need to ask her if I can have Monday off.
He's just a ferret.
A ferret? Whose ferret?
Well, mine, actually.
Yours, actually?
I was gonna tell you.
Sure.
Come on, he won't hurt anybody.
I don't suppose you'd like to tell me what the hell you're doing with that thing.
I'm keeping him, that's what I'm doing.
You got one without talking to me first.
Well, of course. Obviously, by your reaction, you never let me have one anyway.
Jody, why don't you talk to me about things like this? Why are you so afraid to talk to me?
So you don't mind?
What can I do about it now? I don't have time to argue. I need to get to the phone. To do it.
Well, of course I know how.
All right, that should be enough. I'll be across the road. Liz, this is Stacy. Oh, good. We're in Ohio right now. We'll probably be stopping later tonight somewhere in West Virginia. Yeah. Well, I was wondering if maybe I could come in Tuesday instead of Monday. We'll just be getting in tomorrow night, and I just kind of wanted to... Yeah. Great. Okay. Okay, thanks. I'll see you Tuesday then. Okay, bye-bye.
assure you, the patient is harmless. The patient is harmless.
God damn it. God damn it! Shit! Fucking shit! Son of a bitch! God!
What I think it is? A book on ferrets?
Yep. Everything you need to know about them.
Who gave it to you?
Kyle.
Ooh, Kyle.
Chuck's Buffet, located on the west side, shut down early last night.
Hey, is that Kyle's ferret?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, he gave it to you, didn't he, that little monster? That's what he had in his book bag last night, isn't it? Yeah, I'm gonna get you guys. You just wait.
Along with several $1,000 in credit cards and jewelry. Chuck Albright, the owner of the new restaurant, commented, "This is no welcome mat."
Well, Jody, it looks like you might win.
How's that?
I think we'll go ahead and take the interstate once we get to Portsmouth.
Portsmouth? Is that in Ohio?
Uh-huh. We'll be there in about an hour. How about if we check into a hotel somewhere around Charleston? That's West Virginia.
Sounds good to me.
Great. Hey, we finally agreed on something. You know, Jody, I'm really glad we finally worked things out.
What do you mean?
What do you mean, what do I mean? I'm saying I'm glad we're finally getting along here.
Oh, boy.
What?
I wish you wouldn't have said that. Now I'm mad again. Thanks for ruining the mood.
You're kidding me, right?
Gotcha.
Don't you do that to me, little squirt. Jody, get that away from me. I'm serious. Jody, I am driving. Jody, get it away.
Oh, come on. He's just a...
I'll be right there.
Center, hello? Hello?
Karen, it's Jason.
Jason, God, we were starting to get worried about you. St. Paul's called and said that you hadn't arrived yet.
Jason?
Yeah, Karen, I have a little bit of a problem here.
Attention all units.
Yeah? What is it?
Attention all units. Got a possible 220. A young woman passing through Georgetown reports her car being struck from behind by
Karen,
another
hold
vehicle.
On. I'll be right back.
Time. A man driving a blue full-size pickup truck, license plate unknown. The girl's at the abandoned station off 125 in Georgetown, handle code 3.
Yeah, Karen, the van's got two flat tires and the tow truck just pulled up. Gotta go. I'll call you back.
This is 34. I can make it over there in about 5 minutes.
God, I hope I know what I'm doing.
Hello?
Hi, Stacy.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, we have someone on the way. Should be there in a few minutes.
Great.
Valhalla Mills, am I in the right track?
Sure. Head the way you're going and turn right about 3 miles down on 62. Only about 25 miles from there, then. Pass through the old covered bridge, and you'll be right there.
All right. Thanks a lot.
So what's going on here? You know who took my sister, don't you?
He's a mental patient. He's transporting him to Cincinnati and he broke out.
He broke out?
Right.
Did you call the police?
No. Give me the radio. Give me the damn radio. Look, I know what I'm doing. It's my responsibility and I'll take care of it.
This is 34. I'm at the vacant station in Georgetown. The orange bus here.
right back.
Damn it! I need help. Someone, please. Hello? Jody? Say something, please. Hello, if anyone's listening, help me, please. Hello? Thank you.
Stacy, I found the truck. Fuck! Fuck!
Hello. Hello, my name is Stacy Parker. I'm in Valhalla Mills. I need to speak with the police. Hello? Hello? Yes, I'm aware of it. This is an emergency. I called from a phone earlier. My little sister has been kidnapped.
Where about Valhalla Mills are you?
I'm in a vacant house off the main highway. We're both trapped inside.
Okay, stay close, Ms. Parker. I'm going to receive some instructions.
Ha ha ha!
Hey! Come on.
How long has she been like this?
Ever since I found her.
Are you okay? Well, where is he?
He's downstairs.
He's gone.
You're the girl that called about the kidnapping?
Yes, call for an ambulance, please.
I'll have them on their way.
Stacy's little sister. Have someone run up to the hospital. We need a statement from both of them.
You got it.
Jason Inman?
Yeah. Hey, Bob. Come upstairs for a second.
Don't go away.
Assume that's him.
Yeah, that's him.
Okay, that's all we need. Have Pat take him on down to the station for questioning. I'll wait for the other guys.
You want to come with me, sir? Sir?
Yeah.
What a goddamn mess.
Hi, Stacy.
Hi.
I thought I'd offer you a ride to your car, but I see it's already out there. So how's your sis?
I think she's gonna be fine.
Great. That's great. Did you hear they found him?
Yeah, they informed us last night.
Yeah. No, it helped put me at ease anyways. Look, that reminds me, I kind of told the cops that he knocked me out and escaped and that I didn't really have anything to do with this. So, you know, if you could tell him the same story, it really helped me out a lot. Really appreciate it.
Stacy!
Hey, how's my little sis?
Oh, I'm okay.
You as hungry as I am?
Starving.
Great, let's go.
Hi.
Hello there.
Let's go.
So what do you say, Stacy?
Honey, why don't you go get in the car, okay? I'll be there in a minute. In this certain situation, I was on my own, as I've always been. And I won. On my own. Far from being a hero, I did what anybody else would have done. Because in a world that is especially lonely, she's all I have left.
Let him go, bitch. caring relationships.
You guys are disgusting. Stop bothering us.
Now they are totally insane.
What do you mean insane?
Well, I think if you consider what this murderer does to these unfortunate young people, it is somewhat insane.
You killed her!
Oh, yeah, make it hurt, baby.
Spoken Jeffrey over a fucking guy, and I'm not gonna kill you.
Where's Jackie?
She's upstairs. Tired.
Who the fuck can do this to her and Bob? Whoever this motherfucker is, I want him! They want him there! Look everywhere!
The new and truly unsinkable Titanic.
I'm documenting this voyage on canvas for my personal memoirs.
We're gonna go on the most beautiful vacation. All you can think about is your ass.
We are in the hull of the great ship.
It's imperative that we begin an immediate evacuation of the ship. We have an hour, and maybe even less, before we go down.
Lesbian vampire, you're going down.